Game of Thrones' use of music in this episode, especially in the opening sequence, is a work of genius. The entire episode is both visually engaging and musically captivating. Its opening sequence has been rightly compared with the climax of The Godfather, but its execution has a Hitchcockian feel to it. Hitchcock had this famous bomb under the table theory, differentiating surprise from suspense. According to that, a scene holds tension if the audience already has some crucial information that the characters don't. Director Miguel Sapochnik employed the same technique for this sequence, which is a departure from their traditional approach, which uses surprise over suspense to shock the audience while introducing plot twists. Now, to create that Hitchcockian suspense, Sapochnik needed a new piece of music, and for a simple reason. The sequence is about Cersei killing her enemies, so he couldn't use the Lannister theme as it would have spoiled the entire sequence. Then, no matter how effective the scene construction, the climax would have been ineffective. So Ramin Djawadi composed a new piece, Light of the Seven, a piano-driven theme arranged in C minor. Let's see how it helps in storytelling. After introducing the primary characters who will be involved in the sequence, the piece kicks in with a cut to the Great Sept. This opening section introduces the piano in an already rich sonic universe of the series. The high notes of the piano have a unique attack and decay, like a sharp ominous ring with a lingering tail foreshadowing a sinister outcome. This section continues till we reach Pycelle. Then for the next 18 bars, the piano is stripped off of all the other instruments. This section works like a distraction from the main plot. Visually, we move to Pycelle, a subplot character navigating through dim and murky chambers. This is in direct contrast with the well-lit Great Sept, foreshadowing that even if the players are playing in the light, the real game is unfolding under the shadows. Then the music takes a break and allows the plot to unfold.
To which crimes will you be confessing?
All of them.
The piece then returns with the same opening notes, but the violins are now missing. This makes the piano sound even more ominous.
Once the Queen Mother's trial is concluded, Brother Loras is free to leave.
And where is the Queen Mother?
Visually, Sapochnik creates the same ominous effect with shots like these, and with these lines.
Her litter never left the Red Keep.
We now intercut between two different places soaked in shadows. The sharp sound of the piano raises the tension, and then Sapochnik reveals the first bomb underneath the table. We are now traversing through the Hitchcock territory. After 11 minutes of build-up, we know what those ominous opening bars of the piano meant as Pycelle is stabbed to death. The way the organ beats are matched with the stabbing motion, it feels like a reference to the stabbing scene from Psycho. After that brilliant piece of referencing, Sapochnik takes a breather to let the audience gather their emotions.
The longer you wait, the worse it'll be for you.
Even if we are in Hitchcock territory, Djawadi sneaks the main theme in to remind us that this is, after all, Game of Thrones. The piece now moves into its climactic section. The piano rings all alone for the next 8 bars. Sapochnik uses this section to reveal the second bomb underneath the table. Only this time, in the literal sense. As a regular audience of the series, we know that Game of Thrones has never shied away from killing important characters. Even some of the characters know that. The director and the composer use this knowledge to raise the tension. They delay the outcome while swelling the music with the addition of more and more instruments. When bedlam sparks in the Great Sept, the tempo of the music picks up and higher notes are engaged. And when narrative reaches its breaking point, that entire sequence is a great example of fusing visuals and music together to achieve cinematic storytelling. And there are two more moments of such brilliance in the same episode. First is the revelation of Jon Snow's true lineage. As the camera pushes in on the infant's face, the music starts to swell up to build anticipation. When it reaches its tipping point, we get a match cut to Jon's face while the music slips into the Stark theme. With the use of sound and image alone, Sapochnik reveals the true lineage of Jon Snow. No dialogue necessary. It is effective because it is simple. Another such moment takes place in the Red Keep during Cersei's coronation. The scene is presented from Jaime's point of view, who has just witnessed the aftermath of the opening sequence. So rightfully, Javadi starts the scene with the reigns of Castamere. But it is not playing at its full glory. The cellos play at a slower tempo, and the pitch is also at a lower end. It is as if the lion is being suppressed. When Qyburn proclaims Cersei as the new queen, Jaime understands everything. Sapochnik accentuates this revelation by pushing the camera in on both Jaime and Cersei. And with the crowning of the new queen, Javadi plays Light of the Seven. But this version is composed only of cellos and violins, the same instruments that comprised the reigns of Castamere moments ago. And compared to its murky and somewhat diminished tone, Light of the Seven is louder, deeper, and darker. However, the Lannister theme still tries to make its presence felt. But with that brilliant rack focus and an exchange of looks in mid-shots, Light of the Seven completely overpowers the Lannister theme. And we know that their relationship is now on shaky grounds. That is a brilliant piece of cinematic storytelling. It is not the giant dragons or the humongous sets or expensive visual effects that make things cinematic. They are impressive for sure, but it is this intricate weaving of visuals and sound and music together that produces great cinematic moments. Miguel Sapochnik and Ramin Djawadi did exactly that in this episode. Not once, not twice, but three times. This was an episode in which Game of Thrones bridged the gap between television and cinema with brilliant visual storytelling. And then, season 7 happened.